أفلا يتدبرون القرآن
ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سورة المائدة The surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in it the covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to mention in them the covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and trusting the people to hold fast to the books of Allah, to apply, to follow the orders of Allah and to be away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade them. And if they do so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them the happiness in this life and the reward in the hereafter. And whoever turns away from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they have been warned a severe punishment in this life and in the hereafter. And after the verses talked about the Torah and the Injil, the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Musa alayhi salam and Isa alayhi salam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to hold fast to the books of Allah and to follow the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then the verses talks about the Quran and the duty that every Muslim has towards this book of Allah, the final revelation from Allah, and that is in verses number 48 to 50. So inshallah ta'ala we'll reflect upon these verses, try to get the tafsir, the explanation of the meaning of these three verses in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verses number 48 and 49 and 50. So let's start with verse number 48. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 48, وأنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه من الكتاب ومهيمنا عليه فاحكم بينهم بما أنزل الله ولا تتبع أهواءهم عما جاءك من الحق لكل جعلنا منكم شرعة ومنهاجا ولو شاء الله لجعلكم أمة واحدة ولكن ليبلوكم فيما آتاكم فاستبقوا الخيرات إلى الله مرجعكم جميعا فينبئكم بما كنتم فيه تختلفون Which roughly means, and we have revealed to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the book in truth, confirming that which preceded it of the scripture and as a criterion over it. So judge between them by what Allah has revealed and do not follow their inclinations away from what has come to you of the truth. To each of you we prescribed a law and a method. Had Allah willed, He would have made you one nation, united in religion, but He intended to test you in what He has given you. So race to all that is good. To Allah is your return altogether. And He will then inform you concerning that which or that over which you used to differ. So this verse, وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ We brought down to you the book, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Kitab is the Qur'an. وَأَنزَلْنَا We brought down, as it's mentioned before, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا التَّوْرَاةِ That we brought down the Torah and also the Injil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down the Injil, the Gospel to Isa alayhi salam. And the Quran was brought down to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is not something new. ما كنت بدعا من الرسل, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he was not something new among the messengers. Messengers have been sent, books have been revealed, and the final book and the most perfect of all of them is the Quran, and it's the book that is protected till the day of judgment. No alteration, no change in it whatsoever. It's as exactly as it was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's a miraculous thing to the book of Allah. And for the followers of the previous books, if they see clearly the Quran, the book of Allah, there's no even comparison to what is present today, the miraculous words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are preserved, confirming what has been revealed before, and for them to see. And once they see this, then there's no excuse but to follow the Quran, otherwise they become disbelievers. Because what made them believe in the Torah and the Injil should make them also believe in the Quran. And that's a very important point, and we mentioned that before. If you ask someone that believe in the Torah and the Injil from among the Jews and the Christians, what made you believe in them? Of course, the Jews, they believe in the Torah only. The Christians, they believe in the Torah and the Injil. What made you believe in them? What is the criteria that you took to believe in them? Whatever answer is given, then use the same criteria to believe in the Quran. And that's why whoever do not believe in the Quran, they basically disbelieved in the Torah and the Injil before, because they would be contradicting themselves. So the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of it, a person has to believe in it. And that's why we as Muslims, we say that it's part of our faith, part of our belief, to believe in all of the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. And whoever disbelief in any of the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, then he's a disbeliever. And he's not anymore among the believers, even if he believes in all of the books except one. And that's a matter of belief that has to be clear. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying here that he brought down al-kitab, the Quran, وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. We brought down to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-kitab, the book, which is the Quran, بالحق, by the truth. This is the book in truth. The truth in it, and it's revealed by the truth. By the truth, it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the book of Allah, the Quran, has the truth, has the ultimate truth, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ, confirming that which preceded it of the scripture, and also overtakes it as a witness against it or for it. Which means that the book of Allah, the Quran, is basically confirming the previous books, not something new. When it comes to matters of belief, matters of aqidah, it's the same belief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord of all that exists. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, calling the people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, ordering people to establish the prayers, to give the charity, to be kind to the neighbors, and so on and so forth, and giving more and extra rulings that human beings are in need of till the Day of Judgment. This is the most comprehensive one. This is the book that is going to stay with the people till the Day of Judgment, that fits all of their affairs, whatever place they are in, tribes, countries, age, whether it's in the 21st century or the 30th century, whatever there is, then it fits all of their needs and their criteria of life, because that's the final revelation from Allah. Unlike the previous books, it was unique to the nations that was revealed these books to Bani Israel only. But the Quran is different. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ, we brought down to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Quran, al-kitab, bilhaq, in truth, and in it is the truth, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ, as the books confirm what's present in the previous ones, min al-kitab, from all the books, وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْ. مُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْ means to be a witness for the previous books. The validity of the previous books are known by the verses of the Quran. So to validate what's in the previous books, then you would find this in the Quran. So if it's in the Quran, that means that confirms what's in the previous books. And that means this book, the book of Allah, the Quran, abrogates all the previous books. That everybody has to believe in all of the books, but everybody has to follow this book, the Quran, the final revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a result of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ. فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ, judge between them, among them, with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down, meaning in this Quran, and of course in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ عَمَّا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ, and do not follow their inclinations, their desires, away from what has come to you of the truth. So it's always this contrast between the revelation from Allah, which is the truth, versus al-ahwa, versus the desires, the inclinations of the people. And this is always mentioned in the Quran for people to really see whether they are going to follow the revelation from Allah, the wahy, or they're going to follow their own desires. So this is a test that all human beings, they have to go through, whether it's in the general meaning of it, to be believers or disbelievers, or even in matters of halal and haram and worldly affairs and every details in our life. We have to be faced by this test, whether we are going to follow the revelation from Allah or we're going to follow our desires that opposes the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُ لَكَ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يَتَّبِعُونَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. If they don't respond to you, if they don't follow you or Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then know that they had followed their desires. That's why clearly we say that whoever the religion of Islam is being presented to clearly, without any ambiguity, without any distortion, if it's revealed, if it's explained to the person and he refused to follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, we see that that person really followed his or her own desires, not the truth, because the truth is very clear. If people have this eagerness in them that they want to follow the truth, they are seekers of the truth, and they really are fair and just, and they would open their hearts to be able to see the truth, they would see the truth in the religion of Islam, in the Quran, in following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordering the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to judge between them by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ, and do not follow their desires. عَمَّ جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ, away from what has came to you from the truth. It's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to each and every one of us. It's amazing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High, He is ordering His beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the best man ever walked on the face of earth, the most humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most righteous, the one that feared nobody except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say that to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that judge between them by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down and do not follow their desires. Right? It's amazing how this, and it's mentioned again in the next verse. So those who are other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they ought to really listen to these orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to disobey their own inclinations and their desires when it comes to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's either the truth or these desires that never ends. لِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا, to each of you we made شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. شِرْعَة, like sharia, like a way, legislation, orders and so on, and مِنْهَاجًا is the methodology, is the way to apply this sharia or the orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to every nation, every prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, He conveyed to the people their sharia, their way to live their life, the rulings, the permissible things, the non-permissible things, the laws, the legislations, and so on. وَمِنْهَاجَ, مِنْهَاجَ, the way, the path to take, how to understand the religion, how to follow the sharia, how to be steadfast on the truth and the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَجَعَلَكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا, and if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, He would have made you all one nation, one religion. But you see how human beings are. All kinds of beliefs and all kinds of religions, right? Although the truth is one, but it's the qadr of Allah. It's the universal decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that human beings will be in such a state, because the truth is presented to them and they have the choice whether to follow the truth or to follow their desires. And really, when this subject comes, people sometimes they think, most human beings, they follow falsehood. Isn't that a strange thing? Well, if you just reflect upon this, it is true that when you see what is being followed among the human beings in large, it's the desires. When a person desires something, he go after his desire. That's why you'd find how the world of entertainment and the world of just things that people would follow their desires in all kinds of things, regardless whether this is the truth or not. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the human being the intellect, the ability to think, the ability to make decisions, and that they would see the effect of their decisions later in this life or in the hereafter. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the human beings to follow the truth and not to follow their desires. When a person steals, he desired to take a wealth from someone, but the truth, he knows that this is not something that he would like to be done to his own self. So he would see in himself that this is something evil, but he justified it for himself, for whatever desire that he have. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He will, He would make them all one nation, but it's the decree of Allah that He created them in many different ways so that they are tested among one another, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. But we'll continue with that inshallah ta'ala in the next verses after the break, so stay with us inshallah. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Still with verse number 48 in Surah Al-Ma'idah, that talks about the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to be the way for this ummah to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the methodology and the path that it's incumbent upon every person that the message reach him to follow the book of Allah, the Quran, and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we stopped where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this Quran, لِكُلِّنْ جَعَلْنَا مِنْكُمْ شِرْعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for each and every one of you as nations شِرْعَةً, sharia, way, legislation, rulings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a minhaja, and a passage that a person would follow, which is as Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, سُنَّةً وَسَبِيلًا, sunnah, way, which is the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the path to take that way and to understand the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the proper way. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, He would have made all nations one and made all religions one. But people follow different religions, although the truth is only one. But because people are being tested by their own intellect, they're given the choice whether to choose the truth or the falsehood. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لَجَعَلَكُمْ أُمَّةً وَحِدَةً وَلَكِنْ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِي مَا آتَاكُمْ, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, He would have made you one nation, united in religion, but He intended to test you in what He has given you. So this is the qadr of Allah, this is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are tested as human beings. And we saw that how human beings, they follow their desires. Many people, they follow their desires against the truth that they know. They know the truth is one thing, but they would choose to follow their desires. So this is something that human beings, they do, and they make their own choice, and therefore they should prepare themselves for the consequences of their decisions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the human beings to use their intellect to choose the truth and to hold fast to the truth, and calling the believers to be steadfast on the truth and not to follow their desires that opposes the truth, and reminding them that this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, if this is the case, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, as the verse says, race with one another when it comes to matters of goodness. Not just do what is good. Al-khayrat is the plural of khayr or good. فَاسْتَبِقُوا, that means race, right? So this is a very amazing order here from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, building on the facts that we've just heard. These are principles, these are foundations, that why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the books, why the Quran is revealed, why the Quran comes muhaiminan, that means it overtakes all the previous books, that becomes witness over the previous books, and to judge among the people by the Quran and the way the Prophet ﷺ, and don't follow the desires but rather follow the truth, and so on. Therefore, race to all that is good. And as we know, when we think of racing, when you are in a race, you're not satisfied to be the last in the race or the one before last. If you are in a race, that means you want to be first, and you would get out all of your ability, all of your effort. You will exert whatever you have to make sure that the best of you comes in a race. And that's what, when you see people racing, for example, they do the best they can, and therefore they want to be the first, and if not, that they're the second, and so on. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the believers to do what is good, He ordered them to race to all that is good. And that's what we need to reflect upon. Are we in that state of mind, and our hearts are in that state in which we race to do what is good? We are trying our best to be the first, and not just to be satisfied with some goodness that we do. You would find people rather race to commit sins or race to follow their own desires. The believers, they need to race to do what is good, to learn the deen of Allah, to establish the matters of belief, to race to be the first when it comes to our salah, our prayers, our giving charity, kindness, goodness, whatever good deeds, reciting the Quran, making dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be the first when it comes to be in the masjid and Salatul Jumu'ah, for example, or in the different prayers and so on and so forth. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Don't wait, because if you wait, that means the desires will come in place. We need to seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to have this attitude in our hearts that we want to be the first. We want to be among the sabiqeen, those who would the foremost. Why? Because إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ جَمِيعًا فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ فِيهِ تَخْتَلِفُونَ. To Allah, everybody shall return. To Allah is your return altogether. And He will then inform you concerning that over which you used to differ. So since everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore everybody should return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life when it comes to beliefs and legislations and rulings and manhaj and passage and way and path and everything. We should refer everything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because physically everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but then that return into the hereafter to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the judgment will be established, the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no point of return. It's our opportunity in this life to return fully to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with repentance, with racing to do what is good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inform everyone with what they used to differ. Peoples of religions, different faiths, people are arguing, they're debating. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge between them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the matter so clear to them in this life. So those who argue to oppose the truth, they will be exposed in the Day of Judgment. And the goal of the believers in this life is to follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. After that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll talk about these lessons inshallah ta'ala at the end of the episode if we have some time. The next verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in verse number 49, continuing the ruling, to the order to rule by the Quran. That our life should be in such a way that we follow the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. Verse number 49, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَنِحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ وَاحْذَرْهُمْ أَن يَفْتِنُوكَ عَن بَعْضِ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُصِيبَهُمْ بِبَعْضِ ذُنُوبِهِمْ وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِّنَ النَّاسِ لَفَاسِقُونَ. Which means, and judge, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between them by what Allah has revealed, and do not follow their inclinations, and beware of them, lest they tempt you away from some of what Allah has revealed to you. And if they turn away, then know that Allah only intends to afflict them with some of their own sins, and indeed many among the people are defiantly disobedient. Such a powerful verse that talks about the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the ummah, to the nation, to the followers of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Day of Judgment. وَأَنِحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ, and judge between them, بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ, by what Allah has revealed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most wise among the human beings, the best in character, there is no one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala perfected like he perfected the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his speech, in his actions. And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to judge among the people, not by his own decision, by his own wisdom, by his own statements, but rather by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. It's amazing. So that no one would come after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and claim that they have more or better ability or ways to judge among the people by other than that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. If that's to the best man ever walked on the face of earth, then those who came after him, they ought to be the first to use the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنِحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ, that by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down, because it comes from above, comes from the Most High, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He knows best what fits the human beings, and He's the Most Wise, and He's the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ, again it's repeated again, judge between them, follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down, and do not follow their inclinations, the inclinations of the people of Bani Israel, the Jews, as the context of the verses are talking, or the Christians, or the hypocrites, or whatever there is, or your own desires. Do not follow their inclinations, because what they are trying to do And what they would try to do to you is that they would take you away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down to you. They will try to take you away from the Qur'an, from following the Qur'an and the way of the Prophet ﷺ. That's why it says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. Do not follow their inclinations and their desires, because that's not the truth. وَحْذَرْهُمْ. And warn yourself against them. So this is the warning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving to the Prophet ﷺ and to the Ummah of the Prophet ﷺ, to warn oneself from those. وَحْذَرْهُمْ أَنْ يَفْتِنُوكَ. Warn yourself from them deviating you away from some, عَمْ بَعْض, from some of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to you. It's such an amazing verse, again as we said, because they're not going to try to take you away from the Quran in its totality. Of course they would love to do so, but they would try to take you away from some of it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet ﷺ, be warned against them, take precautions so that they don't take you away from some of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to you. So and if they do so, then there's no benefit whatsoever, there's no success whatsoever. That means we're ordered here to take the entire Quran and the way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and not to compromise any part of it, not to compromise any part of the deen of Allah, to take in its totality, and knowing for sure that people will try to take us away of some of it for you to be pleasing to them. They will be pleased for you if you don't talk about a certain subject in the Quran, if you don't apply the entire rulings that is mentioned in the Quran, and so on. So فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا, if they turn away, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُصِيبَهُمْ بِبَعْضِ ذُنُوبِهِمْ. If they turn away from this truth, then know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only intends to afflict them with some of their own sins. And this is also interesting for us to reflect upon. When a person turns away from the truth, and people turning away from the truth are on different levels, but it's because of a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to them. If there is goodness in them, they would not turn away from the truth. So if they turn away from the truth after the matter has been presented to them fully, clearly, then know for sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to punish them as a result of their own sins. If there is truthfulness in their hearts, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them. If they are truly seeking the truth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. But because of their sins, because of their evilness in the hearts, arrogance or whatever there is, that blocks the person away from being guided, and a person becomes punished as a result of turning away. And that's why when we really reflect upon this, never should we ever turn away from anything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet ﷺ. That's different from committing sins. Sometimes human beings are weak, they fall into sins, but to turn away from the deen, to turn away from the truth. And that's why there's major difference between those who would fall into the sin and they know that they committed a sin and they regret the sin and they want to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are totally different than those who would seek excuses or would validate their sinful life, and they would say this is no big deal, they turn away from the truth. Major difference between both. The first type, they are closer to be guided, they're closer to be to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and not the second one. So turning away from the truth is such an evil thing, and it's a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing them as a result of their sins. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with this verse and the next one after the break, so stay with us inshallah. Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulullah. Still in verse number 49 from Surah Al-Ma'idah, the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and to the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to judge among the people by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down in this Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the opposite of that is to be warned against, which is not to follow the inclination of others. And the others, they will try to take you away from some of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. So hold fast to the entire Quran, to the entire revelation, to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and be warned against those who would try to take you away from some of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down. And the part that is whoever turn away after the matter made clear to them, then know that this is a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing them because of their sins. And that's why we have to separate and differentiate between sinful acts that makes a person's heart is broken, the person wants to repent to Allah, they know that they're committing sins, and from those who would turn away from the religion, they don't care, they enjoy their sinful life and so on. This is a more dangerous state that can make the person turn away or away from guidance as a result of their sinful behavior and turning away from the truth. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ لَفَاسِقُونَ, that the sad reality of many of the human beings, that many among the people are fasiqun, are defiantly disobedient. Many of them are disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why you see the sins everywhere, committing sins and following their desires and turning away from the religion, turning away from the truth. And of course, there's always goodness in the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that's why a person should never give up. And there's always goodness, and never should a person say that everybody is being defiantly disobedient or people are destroyed as a result of that, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the authentic hadith, "Man qala halaka an-nas fahuwa ahlakahum," that whoever says people are perished or destroyed or ruined, he's the one that ruined them, or he's the one that is the most among them that is ruined. So, but the point here is, this is a fact of life that is mentioned in the Quran. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also in the Quran, وَإِنْ تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, if you obey most of the people on earth, they would lead you astray from the path of Allah. If we're talking about the shir'ah and the minhaj, the sharia, the orders of Allah and the path of goodness, most people, if you obey them, they would turn you away from this. They would turn you away from the path of Allah. So the obedience, the ultimate obedience, the absolute obedience is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is what we are going to be asked about in the Day of Judgment. Otherwise, if we make ourselves just obeying people, following the inclinations and the desires of the people, whether because they have power or out of the fear that they might harm you, as it will come in the next verses inshallah ta'ala, those who would take or have loyalty to the disbelievers and to the Jews and the Christians out of the fear that they would harm them or so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned against this. They will try to take you away from your religion. They will try to tempt you. They will try to force you. They will try to terrify you, right? So that you would compromise your religion. And that's why when a Muslim sees that how much, so much pressure, you know, among the believers and among, you know, towards the ummah and so on. Why is that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing this ummah to see who would compromise his religion and who would be steadfast. So our duty is to hold fast to the deen of Allah, not to compromise to please others, as we heard. Because most of the people, as the verse says, are fasiqun. They're defiantly disobedient. Not just disobedient, but defiant. They rebel against the orders of Allah. They turn away. They don't really care. So the duty is to be not like this. And even when a person falls into the sin, he's not defiant, but rather he returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with repentance. And then the next verse, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically says what brings from the heart of the believers an answer to a question. The question is very obvious, and therefore the answer should be very obvious. Verse number 50, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. Then is it the judgment of the jahiliyyah, of the time of ignorance, they desire? But who is better than Allah in judgment for a people who are certain in faith? It's a question. أَفَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ. What do they desire? What do they want? Do they want the judgment of the times of ignorance? Time of ignorance, what is life away from the light of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ? Chaos. People shed blood. People have no security whatsoever. They steal. They commit adultery. There is no rights for neighbors or kindness to others and so on and so forth. Maybe sometimes people, when they are rich, when they have money, maybe they would respect certain rules and to have some order and so on. But when they're poor, when there is no state of security, when there are presence of those who are evil, this is the rulings of jahiliyyah, that is away from the deen of Allah. When people would separate one another based on race, based on the color of their skin. These are the matters of Jahiliyyah, as the Prophet ﷺ said to one of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, when he said to Bilal radiallahu anhu, and he was from Abyssinia, he said, Ya ibn al-Sawda, or so the son of the black lady, the Prophet ﷺ, he said to him, Innaka mru'un fika jahiliyyah. He said, you are a person that has jahiliyyah in you. You have ignorance in you, because you call them this. And sometimes human beings, they fall into weakness and they would say something, right? And this is valid to happen sometimes. And you see how the companion of the Prophet ﷺ, when he heard this, immediately what did he do? He went to Bilal radiallahu anhu, and he put his face on the ground and he said to him, step with your foot on my cheeks, so that he would repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from such an evil statement that he made to one of the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. They used to humble themselves. Whenever they're corrected, they would immediately change. And they changed from jahiliyyah, from ignorance, to the light of Al-Islam, to the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. So the question is, أَفَ حُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَبْغُونَ? Something for people really to reflect upon. You would see all rulings on the face of earth that opposes the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not bring anything but corruption on earth. We're not talking about traffic laws, for example. This is valid for people to do such laws, and a Muslim should obey these laws. It's not contradicting to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or opposing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. But rather the rulings that are opposing the orders of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbidding something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid wine and intoxications, and people would say, no, this is legitimate for people to do so. It's okay for people to do so, defiantly disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a result of that, chaos in societies and crimes, there is no limits to it, there's no end to it. The same thing when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid adultery and fornication for the betterment of the people, to save families, to save children from being raised in an evil environment where people would follow their desires, and they would legislate and they would say that this is something, this is the freedom of the people and their choice and things of that nature, that comes into even killing infants and in the wombs of their mothers and so on and so forth. Corruption after corruption, whether it comes to wealth, when it comes to usury, when it comes to adultery, sins in general, associating partners with Allah, it's all the rules of jahiliyyah and ignorance. So what is better? These rules of jahiliyyah, or the rules that comes from the Most High, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that knows best what fits the human beings, and when it was applied, and when it's applied, it brings all kinds of goodness and security and fulfillment of the purpose of one's life, which is the most important thing. When human beings will get to see the truth clearly without being disturbed or distorted away from it. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. Who is better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to judgment? لِقَوْمٍ يُوقِنُونَ. Only for those who have certainty. There's no one. The answer to this, of course, it's a very obvious thing. It's the type of statement that would bring the person from his own mouth to say there's nothing better than the judgment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's the one that created us, so He's the one that knows what's best for us. But to be arrogant and to forget about how we were created and how we have no power, we have no might whatsoever. He's the one that created us from nothing, and we have no power when we were brought to this earth, and we have no power when we depart from it at the moment of death. And also there's no power in this life except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us. He's the one that gives us the ability to talk and to walk, and He gives us the intellect and gives us everything. So therefore, when He reveals to the messengers of Allah how to live one's life, there should be nothing but submission to the Creator of the heavens and the earth, and not to oppose that by one's opinions and intellect and so on and so forth, and inclinations and desires. It's not really intellect, it's all desires to oppose the truth. These three verses, when we reflect upon them, many great benefits. And that's why it's important to reflect upon this and to see, are we really following what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that these books revealed from above the heavens from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people to act and to follow the truth that was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how all the books, they confirm to one thing, and that is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Quran, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ, confirming what has been revealed before in the books before, As the Prophet ﷺ, he said in the authentic hadith, Al-Anbiya ikhwatun li'allat. That means the Prophets are brothers, right? Their deen is one, their religion is one, but their legislations are different. Each Prophet was sent with rulings that would fit the time that he was sent or the nations that he was sent to. But once the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent, he was sent to all mankind. The religion of Al-Islam is valid, fits every place, every time, in any part of the world till the Day of Judgment, because it's the most perfect way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The book of Allah, the Quran, overtakes, abrogates all the previous books and the rulings, with still believing in all the books that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, and as a result of that to judge among the people by what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, and the concept of either to follow the desire or to follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are tested like this in every day in our life, whether to follow the desires or to follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The haqq, the truth, is the goal, is what the believers they seek, even if they have to compromise, and they should not fear anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And knowing the fact that life will continue where people will be different, and there is going to be believers and disbelievers, and good and evil, and so on, for people to get to choose what is good, and to even to learn and to know how to deal with the disbelief and the disbelievers and so on. And therefore, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, again, race to goodness. And that's something that we should learn always whenever we reflect upon the verses of the Quran, not just to be satisfied by doing some goodness, but rather to race. And when a person is in an environment where people are racing to do good, he would find himself easy for him to do even better. But when the environment is in such a way that people are more inclined to follow their desires and committing sins, a person finds himself not really inclined to race in matters of good. There's nobody to race with him. So he finds himself, if he goes and do a good deed and he goes late and he doesn't do it in the most perfect way, he might think that he's the best because nobody else is with him. Like a person in a classroom or so, and he's the only one that is attending the exam, he's the first, because there's no second, there's no last. So that's why when at times when there's not too much help when it comes to matters of goodness and so on, still the person, he should do the best he can, فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, and not just to be satisfied by what the norm of the people is. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, race to do what is good, and الْخَيْرَاتِ in plural tense, in everything that is good. And to remember that whatever we do, whatever we intend, whatever we seek rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, never to forget that we all shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The belief in the last day, it's not an article of faith that we learn in the subject of aqidah and then our life is totally separated from that. In every deed that we do, whether it's seeking knowledge, learning the knowledge, salah, zakah, whatever there is, we should always remember the hereafter. We're doing that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, the desires are mentioned more than one time because it's going to be always the case. People turning away from the orders of Allah, that's a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto them. Warn yourself against those who would take you away from some of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. And there's nothing more beautiful than the orders of Allah. Otherwise, it's jahiliyyah, it's ignorance, it's really foolishness to turn away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ
وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.
يتدبرون القرآن
ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.